The print module is a great place to go if you want to print images. It's also a good place to go if you like creating custom collages, and you can also use it to save JPEG files to print in offsite labs or as photos that you'd like to share online. The template browser has a good selection of templates that you can start out with. You can also create your own and save them to your own folders. Just below that, the page setup button will allow you to create a custom page or a custom document size. Over on the right are all the panels that you'll use to adjust the content inside of your document. The layout style will affect some of the actual panels. If I go from the single image or contact sheet setting down to the picture package, the names of some of the panels have actually shifted to different things. The image settings is where you will select things such as zoom to fill, rotate to fit, and you can also set borders and strokes on your images. The rulers, grids, and guides section allows you to set the ruler units. If you prefer to not use inches, you can choose a different setting. The grid snap setting allows you to keep your images aligned. Each of those image boxes is called a cell. And so right now, this is set to snap to cell, so that way all of my cells will be aligned. If I change it to grid, then it helps keep me in line with the grid. And you can also turn it off as well. If you prefer not to see the guides, you can check individual options, or you can just click the box at the top to hide all of them. If at any time you see this little exclamation point at the top, that's telling me that some of the cells inside of my document are overlapping. That's probably due to the fact that I just moved one of them around. So if I go ahead and reposition it, then that exclamation point disappears. The cells panel is where you can customize the cells. I'm in a picture package right now, so all of the cells are going to be repeated. I can clear the layout and then start adding my own cells. If I were to change this into a custom package, the cells will add, but no images will be added alongside. I would need to drag and drop those images myself to determine which photos I would like in each of those cells. The page panel allows me to add things such as a colored background. I can also add text in the form of an identity plate or a watermark. And you can also set this to print cut guides, which will make it easier for you to cut your print packages after they are printed on paper. And then the print job allows you to either print to JPEG or to a printer.